Good morning, my dear brothers and sisters. Good morning, brother.
Good morning, good morning.
How are you today?
Very fine, praise God.
And we thank God for this beautiful day. We have seen the scripture, "For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believes in him shall not perish but have eternal everlasting life." We have spoke about God loving the world and what is the world. Now I want to know, why did God sacrifice his only Son to us?
Praise God. Now it goes back in the Garden of Eden.
Okay.
Okay. Now when God created man, his son,
yeah,
Adam.
Yeah.
He created him in his likeness and image.
Okay.
He gave him all dominion. He gave him everything.
Okay.
And it was Adam who disobeyed God.
Yes.
Now my question to you is, don't you think God is partial? Because who ate the fruit first, Eve or Adam?
Eve.
And Eve ate the fruit first, and she went and gave the fruit which God said not to eat.
Yes.
And she went and gave the fruit to Adam.
Adam.
Okay. So in the natural, Eve ate the fruit first, and therefore sin would come through her.
Yes.
But the Bible does not say sin came through the woman, but from man.
Yeah.
The reason is that when God gave this command not to eat the fruit, he gave it to Adam, and Eve was not created.
Right.
Now look at her, so happy she is. Because sin did not come from woman, but it came from man. Praise God.
Praise
okay,
God.
Now, one man disobeyed.
Yeah.
And death came into this world.
Yes.
Through that one man's disobedience, sickness came, disease came, sorrow came, curse came, all the things of evil came.
Yes.
So if one man disobeyed God, and the whole human race came under the power of sin and death, God needs one more man to obey him.
Okay.
Okay? So that through his obedience, the whole human race can be turned around, and the law of the Spirit of life in Christ Jesus can be activated.
Amen.
Like on the first day I said, when God created Adam, he spoke the word, and the law of life got activated.
Yeah.
But when Adam sinned, a law got activated because of Adam's action.
Yes.
Was a law of sin and death.
Yes.
So when Jesus came to the scene, he came to reverse what Adam had done.
Amen.
By his obedience.
Amen.
And that is why Romans 8 verse 2 says, first 8 verse 1 says, now therefore there is no condemnation. That means there is no accusation.
Amen.
There is no judgment. Why? Because every sin that I've committed, Jesus has already taken it into his body on the cross.
Praise God.
So there is now no condemnation, not to everyone, but to those who are in Christ, one, who do not walk after the flesh, but walk after the Spirit.
Okay. Amen.
And then he says, for the law of the Spirit of life in Christ Jesus.
Okay.
So all that Jesus has done for me, when I agree it, when I believe it, that law of the Spirit of life in Christ Jesus has set me free from the law of sin and death.
Praise God.
So one man's disobedience brought so much, so another man's obedience brought life in abundance. Now,
Amen.
Please understand that the effect of sin has destroyed the human race.
Okay.
So now when God sent his son Jesus to this world, into this world, he did not send his son Jesus to balance the scale.
No.
Now when Adam committed sin, Adam was the God of this planet earth.
Yes.
He is receiving the authority from God.
Yes.
Using it on God's behalf.
Yes.
And expanding God's kingdom on earth. So God's kingdom is in heaven. Adam has been chosen as the leader to establish his kingdom on earth.
Yes.
And now his children will carry out that job.
Yes.
But because of Adam's disobedience, instead of the kingdom of God ruling over earth, the kingdom of darkness came, and now it's ruling over the earth.
Yes.
So when Jesus came, Jesus fought the battle spiritually. Because if you see in the natural, when Jesus dies on the cross, it looks like he's a loser.
Yeah.
Okay?
Yes.
Because if you and I are in the boxing match and
yeah.
I knock you out
yeah.
and you died in the ring,
yeah.
I win the match.
Yes.
So when Jesus died on the cross, it looks like Satan crucified Jesus
yeah.
and it's the end of the game.
Yeah.
But in the spiritual realm, Satan tried his best to get him into disobedience
yes.
and Jesus obeyed even unto death
yes.
and therefore he won the match.
Praise
now,
God.
When he won the match, he did not win the match just to balance the scale. He won the match in such a way that now through the grace of God
yeah.
and the gift of righteousness that comes from God.
Praise God.
So on one side I have the promise of God and on the other side all my past, present and future, which the devil had legal right to accuse me, has been taken by Jesus
okay.
and nailed on the cross
okay.
and now I have the righteousness of God.
Amen.
So a person who has got the grace of God and the righteousness of God,
amen.
The Bible says such a person will rule or
amen.
Reign in life
amen.
Through Christ Jesus.
Praise God.
So this is what God wants to do. He doesn't want you to just be free from sin that Satan comes and catches you again. No, mm. no. When Adam committed sin, man was right down
okay.
and Satan was on the top, his master.
Okay.
Now when Jesus is sent by God to take a place, the scale has reversed it now by Jesus
yeah.
that he has not balanced the scale.
No.
He has put Satan right down, and we are on the top
yes.
because Jesus is the head and we are his body.
Amen.
And that's why spiritually Satan is under our feet.
Amen.
Praise God.
Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
And that's why he says he gave his only begotten Son. So when you love somebody, you are always a giver.
Amen.
There are two kinds of people on this planet Earth.
Yeah.
Either you are a giver or a getter.
Mm-hmm.
So God is a giver.
Yes.
Love is a giver.
Yes.
Selfishness is a getter.
Yes.
What can I get?
Yes.
So when God gave his Son, he has finished it on the cross for everybody.
Yeah. Amen.
Now the question is, he never said, look here, that whosoever believeth in him. He did not say whoever prays to him.
No.
Whoever believes in him is sacrificed,
yes.
his word and his spiritual truths.
Okay.
When you believe in him, you will not perish, but you will not only everlasting life is that you know God and you know Jesus.
Okay.
Personally.
Yes.
So now you are practicing his principles.
Yes.
So now it is not only you have been saved, but now you are going around bashing up the devil everywhere
amen.
With the power of God that
amen.
Is in you. And
yes.
that's what is love. Love is
yes.
not about setting you free and you keeping you in one corner.
No.
But just as his Son Jesus did, he went about doing good
yeah.
and healing all who are oppressed by the devil.
Yes.
In the same way Jesus God is sending his Son Jesus to empower us with the same anointing
yes.
that we can go about doing good and healing all who are oppressed by
amen.
The devil.
Amen. Praise God.
Because the Lord is with us.
Yes.
And that's what. So all those who believe in him are the ones who will not perish but be overcomers,
praise
victorious
praise
and
God.
Conquerors
praise
in
God.
The name of Jesus.
Praise God. Praise God. And thank you, brother. Thank you for coming into my life, because it is Brother Johnson who gave me Jesus, the gift of Jesus, who explained to me the word of God. And today I'm really, really enjoying the amazing love of Jesus.
Now, when you did not have Jesus, you were born in a Christian family.
Yes.
But you did not have the truth.
Yes.
So the grace was available.
Yes.
The righteousness was available.
Yes.
But not knowing, you were being bashed up by the devil.
Yes.
So you must have been an expert in praying but not believing.
No.
So when a preacher comes and preaches you the truths from the Bible and you begin to understand, you are no longer a person who is perishing, but you are going around bashing up the devil and setting the captives free.
Every day bashing up the devil.
From how long have you been touched?
1 year passed.
So this 1 year, I'm not asking your age, sorry. This 1 year and all your life that you lived,
yeah.
is it a different life?
Of course it is a different life. It is a very much different life. Just happy and enjoying with my family. And my house is also saved. It's all because God sent him into my life. Just as God sent Jesus into the world, God sent him as a servant of God into
my life. To reveal to you
to
the
reveal
truth.
To me that
and it is
truth.
Jesus who is working in you.
Yes.
Not
it
me.
Is Jesus. No.
I am a person.
Don't take the message wrong.
Okay.
Yeah.
I am a person who received the seed from the Lord, yeah. and I came and planted the seed, and the seed is Jesus.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Praise God. So let's pray for the people.
Let's say a small prayer.
And I want you to agree with me, okay?
Yes, brother.
Heavenly Father, I and my precious sister Sarita, we come together and we pray, Lord, that all those who are listening right now, the message of the gospel, which is the power of God for everyone who believes, power of God for salvation, power of God for healing, for deliverance, for protection, for prosperity, for the fullness of God, for everyone who believes. So Father, in the name of Jesus, Amen. Just as you said, let there be light in our heart, and
Lord.
That light is shining.
Yes, Lord.
Right now, I and my sister, we come together in
Lord.
Faith and we speak to you, my friend. Let there
Lord.
Be light in your heart and every member of your family, that every member is
Lord.
Being touched right now. God, send forth your laborers
Praise
in their life
Jesus.
That they will receive the gospel of Christ.
Thank you, Lord.
And the whole family is completely saved and transformed, and not only really saved and transformed, but mighty warriors
the
in the kingdom of God.
Yes, Lord.
Father, thank you for the supernatural breakthrough. I can hear in my spirit, chains are broken,
Amen.
Sicknesses are destroyed,
Amen.
The works of the devil are completely uprooted
Amen.
From the root
Amen.
In the name of Jesus,
Amen.
And the blessings of God and the favor of God is on
Amen.
You and your family
Amen.
Every day of your life.
Amen.
And a special anointing above all this, a powerful thirst and hunger and an anointing to study the word and understand the word
Amen.
And live by the word like never before in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
God bless you in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen.
And you all have a beautiful, blessed and
oh,
peaceful
yeah,
day.
Oh, yeah, yeah. God bless you. Come on, give a five. Praise God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Jesus.